Spark SQL has inbuilt optimizer called Catalyst Optimizer. Whenever we do any transformation, we will be giving the instruction on how the data should get transformed from one form to another form. Whenever we are taking an action, the data needs to be derived. So whenever we give an action, the Catalyst Optimizer makes n number of logical plan how it can transform that particular data frame or data set into another data frame or the result that we are looking at. And it's going to evaluate all the logical plans, and then it will create an optimal logical plan which is going to give a very low latency, as well as it's going to utilize the resources to the minimal. Then it will be creating n number of physical plans based on the cost, what's the network cost involved and how much amount of data needs to be transferred. It will look for the plan where the data going to get transferred to the minimal, as well as going to consume the resources to the minimal. And based on that, it's going to create the plan which will generate the resultant RDD that's going to be another data frame or data set. Finally, that would get stored internally some way, either in RDBMS or in NoSQL database or in any other file system or any messaging system. And Catalyst Optimizer internally, it uses a specific feature or a specific optimizer called Tungsten, and the data frame and data sets are majorly benefited out of this particular Tungsten optimizer. It's going to improve the efficiency of the memory and CPU, and it's going to eliminate the unnecessary movement of the data. Simple example, further down the line, if I'm going to do any filter operation, rather than reading the data and then filtering it, it will try to filter the data while reading itself. And it's going to divide the data into multiple stages. So even if any data is lost due to the physical failure of the machines or the network unavailability, it should be in a position to regenerate the data with minimal resource utilization. So the Catalyst Optimizer, that's going to be the working horse internally for the Spark SQL. And that's what makes the Spark SQL very effective in terms of execution as well as the result generation. And it's going to create n number of transformations based on what transformation that we are doing against the data set or data frame. Internally, when it is working with the optimizer, it does two type of optimization, logical and physical optimization. Simple example for the logical optimizations, whenever we are using a filter condition at the end, it's going to apply the filter condition at the source itself. No need to read the entire data, only the filter data would be read. That is reading only the required data. And optimizing the query so that it can be optimized at the RDBMS side itself. Whenever I am reading some conditional data, I can use the where condition as a part of RDBMS and read only the required data. And convert every comparison to a cheaper comparison option. For example, if I am going to compare two string operations or two string, if I am going to compare, it would generate a reference dictionary. Using the reference dictionary, it's going to do the comparison using the integers. Integer comparisons are always much cheaper than the string comparison, and that would save us lots of CPU cycle. And any data, if it is optimized or bucketed in terms of within SQL, I can arrange the data based on some conditions or based on the key. It knows what are all the blocks having that particular key, and it will read that particular block only if it's going to have some data within that particular key. So this type of optimizations happen as a part of logical optimization. And within the physical optimization, it's going to use different type of serializer and codec to reduce the network traffic. If it has to transfer the data from one system to another system for any join operation or any comparison, it will serialize the data and compress the data so that it can consume less amount of network resources. And it uses some optimization techniques like broadcast variables and accumulators, where any data that's going to get referred more frequently, it can be distributed across multiple systems. As well as whenever I wanted to do atomic counting, I can use concepts like accumulators. We will see more in detail about broadcast variables and accumulators later point of time. And before doing the join, if we sort the data accordingly, the Cartesian product that's going to get created would be very less. And send across only the data that is required to be processed over the network. So this type of optimization will help to get the result much faster and quicker. And Catalyst Optimizer generates various options and evaluates different optimization technique and is going to choose the best out of various options based on the cost evaluation. The explain command of any query going to give us the optimization, what optimization and how it is going to read the data. For example, I can give the data frame dot explain. It will give me what are all the things that's going to do, the physical plan, how it's going to read the data. This is a very simple data frame where it is going to read from the file. Later point of time, when we get into the transformations where we can do different type of transformations like removing a column, transposing the table, after doing all those instructions, I can give explain command against that particular data frame or RDD or data set that would give me the physical plan, how it planned to execute that particular transformation and how it's going to act against that particular transformation.